next petrifying pit stop is here. A suburb southwest of Chicago called Justice, Illinois. Ride with us down Archer Avenue, but be warned. We're sharing this thoroughfare with one seriously disturbed spirit.
Because of the history and the death along it, it's become known as really one of the most haunted roadways, not only in Chicago, but anywhere in the country.
Her name is Resurrection Mary. And since the 1930s, she's been making this unassuming avenue one of the most eerie roads in America. Legend has it that one night in the early 1930s, Mary and her boyfriend attended a dance at the O. Henry Ballroom, now known as the Willow Brook. It was an evening of harmless fun, until...
They had been dancing, got into an argument, and she laughed, and was walking up Archer Avenue when she was struck and killed by a hit-and-run driver. And her grieving parents buried her in Resurrection Cemetery.
But Mary never got the chance to rest in peace.
In the 1970s, Resurrection Cemetery began moving what were called term graves into different burial spots. Now, the term graves were sort of like rental spots. They were for bodies to be stored until an actual plot could be purchased.
In the 70s, they had actually moved Mary's grave from where it was to an unmarked grave in another part of Resurrection Cemetery.
And the disturbance of Mary's resting place seemed to have paranormal consequences.
A lot of people, they believe that when they moved her grave, she would leave the cemetery, but then she couldn't find her grave because they had actually moved it.
It makes you wonder if perhaps the disturbance of these graves is really what sort of kicked off this cycle and caused the ghost to be seen on Archer Avenue.
Soon, reports were coming in of a strange spectral girl wandering Archer Avenue. Resurrection Mary. Some claim her spirit is desperately searching for someone to lead her back to Resurrection Cemetery.
There was a young man, his name was Jerry Palis. He actually met a young woman one night at a dance, a pretty blonde woman. Spent the entire evening with her. They had dinner together, they had drinks together, he danced with her. He even claimed that he kissed her a couple of times. At the end of the evening, he offered her a ride home, which she accepted. Jerry then took her down Archer Avenue, right across the street from Resurrection Cemetery. He offered to drive her the rest of the way home. Instead, she put her hand on his and said, "Where I'm going, you can't follow." Got out of the car, ran across the road directly toward the gates to the cemetery, and disappeared. Now, it was at that point that Jerry claimed that he realized he'd spent the entire evening with a ghost.
Oh, but one phantom joyride? That isn't enough to make this one of America's creepiest thoroughfares. Pull up a chair at Chet's Melody Lounge. Since the 1960s, they've been serving drinks directly across the street from Resurrection Cemetery. All too convenient for a thirsty ghost.
Many years ago, a cab driver actually came in at 3 o'clock in the morning and asked my father, who was tending bar at the time, where the girl was. He said he picked up a girl, asked to stop here to use the bathroom. My father and the customers that were here had no idea what he was talking about because the door never opened. He said he'd seen her come in here, and he thought that she was trying to just stiff him for the cab ride. So he was irate, and my father said, well, no one came in. The customer said no one came in, and the cab driver thought that everyone was just sticking up for this girl. So my father let him look through the place, and he just said, well, there's nobody here. He just shook his head and left.
So next time you're flagged down by a strange young woman on Archer Avenue, take our advice. Keep driving.
I think what really scares people about the story of Resurrection Mary is that you're not even safe in your own car. You could be touched by the supernatural just driving down the road.